Well, good morning and welcome to your Sunday Gardener. I'm John Collins along with Carrie Engel.
Hello.
Valley View Farms. You know, when you go into a garden center like yours, you see a lot of hanging baskets.
You do.
They're extremely popular. You drive down the street, they're hanging on the porches and everywhere else. Very popular, but they don't always have to hang, do they? And they're beautiful plantings.
That is, that's exactly right. And more, there are some combinations that are just terrific in here. Mm-hmm. And people have a hard time maybe putting together their own pots that are down at a lower level. Mm-hmm. So we're telling you, cheat. Start with the hanging basket.
We always cheat. Yeah.
Make it easy on ourselves.
So lots of hanging baskets. So we have an example here. This is a mix of, whoa, that's heavy. It's just been watered.
Yes, it has.
All right. This is a mix of petunias and what's a white
verbena.
Plant? Verbena.
And these are both great trailing plants. They bloom all summer long. Butterflies love them.
And this guy has got a real head start here. I mean, this has been going for a while.
It has. And we started all these at our farm some time ago.
The advantage of getting them this way is instant flower.
Exactly. Right. And they're still going to go until frost. Well, actually beyond frost, because they'll take it down pretty low. But here's a way we're cheating. We're taking, this is called an upsidaisy planter insert. And we're taking our big pot here.
All right. So these are a problem. One, you have to put a lot of dirt in these.
You do.
Soil,
there you go.
Yes.
Thanks, John.
And some of these don't have drainage in them. You'd have to drill a hole or something anyway.
Exactly.
But this guy's in there, and it shortens the, well, you can see the water standing down in it, okay? It gives you drainage, and you don't have to put as much soil in there
if
you were going to plant it with soil. But also,
show you our easy, breezy way to put together a nice container.
Boop.
One and done.
All done.
Take a pair of wire cutters or just bend these out of here. You can take that wire out of there and not even worry about it. And you can use it for a lot of different things. So here I took this kind of uniquely shaped planter.
Okay, let me get your microphone cable.
Okay.
And again.
So we put the upsidaisy in there. Now the hanging basket's a little shallow for that. And you can direct plant in this. It's not that you have to put a pot in here.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm taking a diplodenia here.
A what?
Diplodenia.
Diplodenia.
Related to the mandevilla.
Okay.
And putting it in there, and again, you're done. You could do this with drift roses. You could do this with anything. I mean, any tree, shrub, in some of these containers, and really, not so backbreaking to move around.
And if you have a little scratch, and about halfway through the summer, you get tired of your diplodidia, or it's not doing well for some reason,
heaven forbid,
out it goes.
That's
just
right.
Buy something fresh and put it in there.
Exactly, and it's great. I mean, you and I are kind of the same, but I like to move with the season. So pansies in the spring, beautiful summer annuals, mums and pansies again in the fall, and then in the winter I can even take this out and do something for the wintertime, do some conifers or whatever.
Yeah, right, a Christmas display or
anything
like that. And you're shortening the pot by using a device like that. And even if you're planting with soil, you don't have to use as much soil that way.
Exactly, and it's also great. We've talked a million times before how often people can overwater their plants or there's insufficient drainage, and this is going to give you all of that. So it's a nice little cheater.
Speaking of drainage, we have a couple of seconds left here. There's another little device that's very simple, and you have to kind of get the concept here. It's a little foot, a pot on your deck, and this raises it. What, a half inch?
Just enough so that excess water can get out of there. Because again, we take these pots, we put them right on the deck. If they did have drainage, they don't anymore. But these little pot toes are just smaller versions of pot feet, but they allow that excess water to drain out of there.
And
you just need like three or four for a big container.
Right.
And it's enough to level it out.
The drainage is better and it's not rotting the wood underneath
with
all that,
that
water sitting there. Okay, a great little idea or two. For your garden, something to give a little more variety to your hanging baskets, too, because there are some beautiful arrangements out there.
They really are, and I like the fact that somebody else has done all the work.
There you go. All right. We're cheating a little bit
again
on Sunday Gardener. Next Sunday, we'll try again. Talk about your garden. We'll see you then.
And if you have a gardening question, you can send it to Sunday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211. You can also go to our website, WBALTV.com.
The time right now.